Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On this episode, let's take a look at the new lock screen in iOS 10. So here's the lock screen of iOS 10. It doesn't look that much different. You've got the wallpaper background. You've got some basic information at the very top there, like Wi-Fi and the amount of power you've got. Think of the bottom now, and that shows that you've got three different screens. So we can swipe a little bit left or right to go to see those screens there. If I were to swipe left, it reveals to the right the camera. And before you had this as a camera icon, and you swipe. So now it's kind of a regular screen on par with the main lock screen and the widget screen, which we'll see in a second. If you want to exit this screen, you just press the home button again, and it takes you back to the main lock screen. Now if I swipe to the right, it takes me to what's called the widget screen. And this is very new. Before you would have seen things like notifications and such on the main lock screen. And it was kind of confusing to what would be presented there as opposed to what's presented on the regular notification screen. Here it's a little more clean cut. You see information like weather and time at the top, as well as a search box that you can search your iPad for whatever. It's a spotlight search. You can search for apps, information, anything. And then you see a list of basically notifications and other kinds of widgets that you can customize. And here I've got some basic ones. Calendar, some Siri app suggestions, which are basically apps I have most recently used or most commonly used. The news app, reminders, music, and some incoming mail. And an edit button at the bottom. Now I'm still in the lock screen. I have not logged in. I haven't entered my passcode yet. So if I were to try to do anything, like say, let's tap on this event here, it's going to ask me to enter Touch ID here because I'm still technically locked out of my iPad. The same as if I'm on this screen here, I'm technically locked out. I can, of course, with Touch ID, just put my thumb on the home button there to get in. And if I was to do that by using any of the functions here, it would take me right to it. So, for instance, if I wanted to actually go to that calendar event, I could tap it, and then right now I'm going to put my thumb on the home button, and it takes me right to it. So back to the lock screen here. Let's say I want to change what's available here on this screen, the widget screen. I can hit the edit button. I'm going to have to go into my iPad here, so unlock it. And it takes me to the screen here that's separate from settings. So this isn't in the actual settings app. This is a separate screen that you get to by hitting that edit button. And I can determine what's in here. And you can see tons of different apps, including third-party apps, allow me to add widgets to the home screen. And I can use the plus button to add them. So for instance, I could add notes to it. I can remove notes by tapping the minus button there, remove it, and it just goes back down to the bottom. And I can also use the three lines to the right to tap and drag and move things around. So I can determine what's there. Now notice it says left column, right column. On the iPad, if I hold it in horizontal mode, it will divide the widgets between left and right. So I can determine which one goes in which column. Otherwise, they just appear in the order starting with the left column and then going on to the right column. After I've customized what I want, I can hit done and it will return to the screen and you can see the changes. Mail is now higher up, for instance, in there. So I can play around with what I want to be on this lock screen. Now, this lock screen is not only available there, the widget screen, it's not only available on the lock screen, but on the home screen if you swipe right from the first screen on the home screen, you get to the same widget screen. So it's available as part of the lock screen and it's available as part of the series of home screens. The difference being here, of course, is I'm already logged in, so I can actually tap on something and it will take me right to it. So I can tap on one of those apps or a mail message or something and go right to that piece of information in the app that's appropriate without having to then enter the passcode. I can also access Control Center by swiping up from the bottom of the screen, and I can do that while on the lock screen. So you can see the padlock at the top. I'm on the lock screen and I can access Control Center and all the different screens of Control Center in there. If I don't want to be able to access that while I'm on the lock screen, I can go into Settings and under Control Center I can turn that off to restrict access. So one last thing I want to point out is that you can add apps in multiple ways. You notice here at the top I've got Calendar app and then I've got something called Up Next. And you can see by the icon there that that's also part of the calendar app, but it's a different widget. And if you look down further, you can see there's Maps Destinations, Maps Nearby, Maps Transit. So you can have one app that offers multiple widgets to give you multiple functionality inside of the widget screen on the lock screen or the home screen.